see, this is one type of classification we have, which is based on the structural unit present. Okay. Classification of polymer is also there on the basis of source. So write down the next one. Classification based on, I'll just write down the second one here. The heading is classification based on source. Based on source, we have two types of polymers. One is natural polymers, which exists naturally. That's the name suggests. Write down just one line. Polymers which are found in nature. Like animal, plants are natural polymers. Okay, like starch. Example, I'll write down here. Natural polymers, the examples are starch, cellulose, protein, proteins, nucleic acid, etc. Nucleic acid we haven't done, no, in biomolecules.
No, sir, that part was left out.
Achha, I'll do that. Nucleic acid, curling hum log. It takes half an hour. Okay, we'll finish that. It's not that important for, you know, chemistry point of view, but we'll go through once. Okay, we'll do that. Okay, these are natural polymers. Second one is synthetic. Synthetic means what? Man-made. Any example of synthetic polymers?
Nylon, rayon.
Yes. Nylon, polythene, polystyrene, PVC, bakelite, dacron. Write down all these examples. Nylon, polyethylene, polystyrene, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, bakelite, dacron, D-A-C-R-O-N. Okay. Now, the another type of classification we have, which is based on structure. I'm not giving you this, just you listen to me. Based on structure, we have linear polymers, branched chain polymers, and three-dimensional network polymers. Okay, in three-dimensional network polymers, there are cross-linked. I'll just draw the structure here. You see, the first one we have, like, theory I'm not giving you. Just you draw the structure because these are not important. Based on source. Classification based on source, you write down. See, one thing I'll tell you here. That for these chapters, okay, like we have polymers, biomolecules, to a certain extent, biomolecules to a certain extent, then surface chemistry, chemistry in everyday life. For these chapters, NCERT is more than enough. You don't have to read any other book, okay, from beginning to end. Focus should be on NCERT. They prepare questions directly from NCERT. They pick one or two lines and they prepare questions from that. Okay. So my suggestion is I'll cover everything here in the class. But when you want to go through on your own, just read NCERT. For questions, you can refer the assignments or any other book. Okay. But for theory part, don't go to any other book that you have. NCERT is more than enough for theory. Okay. Yes. So theory part will focus on whatever, theory given in NCERT, not more than that. Okay. Based on structure, we have three types of polymers. The first one is linear polymer. अब देखो, is the name suggest linear polymer में क्या होगा? Will have a linear structure. इसमें कोई भी branch नहीं होगा, ठीक है?
Sir, it should polymer. Be based on structure, man.
Based on structure, yes. It is source. I have written by mistake. Make it structure. It means you are not sleepy. Yes, Paras.
Sir.
Based on structure. Okay. So, like I said here, there is linear polymer. There's no branch into it. It's a linear polymer like this. So it's just a one layer. So you can have another layer like this one. Like this. So it is a linear polymer. Oh, it looks good. Second one we have branched chain polymer. Like the name suggests, in this we have branches also. For example, you see, this is the polymer we have, suppose, and in this we have branches present like this. This is branched chain polymers. Third one is we have three-dimensional sheet structure. Three-dimensional network polymers also we call it as. Three-dimensional network polymers. Three-dimensional network polymers. In this we have cross-linking. Write down. In this, we have cross-linking. Cross-linking means what? Suppose this is the layer one. Another layer. We have another layer like this. All these layers, like here, these are linked together by some bonds. Okay, this is cross-linking. See, this one is cross-linking. Like this, the cross-linking were present. Okay, so write down, this is the cross-linking we have. So because of this cross-linking, their strength increases a bit, okay? So these kind of polymers are hard, rigid, and brittle.
So can you give an example for a 3D thing?
Acha, I'll give you. Write down, these are hard, rigid, and brittle. The example of this is bakelite. Urea formaldehyde polymer. Write down. Urea formaldehyde polymer, bakelite, melamine formaldehyde polymer. I'll give you examples for all three. Because examples important here. For this, it is polythene. Nylons, polyesters. Nylons, polyesters. For this one, we have glycogen, amylopectin. Amylopectin is there in amino acids. We'll discuss that. One type of amino acid we have this. And this is bakelite, urea formaldehyde, and melamine formaldehyde polymers.
So what kind is starch?
Sorry?
Starch comes under which category, sir?
Starch comes under the third one, three dimensions.
Because amylose and amylopectin.
Yes, yes. Because all these starch proteins, cellulose, they have very, very, very complex structure. Okay, very large, huge, complex structure we have. In all these, we have cross-linking, right? Last class, we were discussing proteins, how they form, There will be cyclic, helical structure because of hydrogen bonding and all. So there are cross-linking present in all these kind of molecules. Starch, cellulose, proteins, and all. All these comes under three-dimensional network. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, there are a few examples we'll discuss. Like I said, other, classification also we have. Classification based on synthesis. Okay? How the polymers forms. Two types of reaction generally we have. Addition and condensation. Right? So that we call it as addition polymerization and condensation polymerization. Addition polymerization, two molecules joins together. Okay? In condensation, like molecules like H2O, NH3 goes out and they joins together. Okay? So that we'll discuss in reactions involved in polymerization. So that is also one kind of classification. And we say this as what? Based on synthesis. Means what reaction we are using for the synthesis of one kind of polymers. So that is also comes under classification, but we'll do that in reactions involved in polymerization. Okay. So before going into that, there are a few examples that we should know. The examples, the first one is H2C double bond CH2. What is the name of this molecule?
Ethylene.
Okay, both we can say. So when it goes under polymerization, it gives you what? It gives you polyethylene. Polyethylene or polyethene also you can say, which we use in plastic bags. So this is ethylene. And on polymerization, it gives polyethylene. Okay. What is the structure of this polyethylene? It is like this. We have CH2, 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 and so on. In short, we can also write this as open bond CH2, CH2, open bond, bracket and N. This is actually represent that there are N such molecules present in this. And that's why this is polymer and the name of this is polyethylene. Am I clear? For polymerization, what happens? We should have a definite pressure, temperature, or catalyst. So whatever is required will provide here for this reaction. And then the reaction takes place. Okay? So the method by which this monomer, ethylene, this monomer converts into polymer, those methods are polymerization technique. And this phenomenon is polymerization. Okay. What is the use of polyethylene? Use in the formation of plastic bag. Jo ki banned ho gaya hai Bangalore mein. You know that?
Yes, sir.
If you're using plastic bag, if you're carrying some goods in the plastic bag, then they can ask you for 2,000 rupees fine. You know that. This shop shall liya, shop wale ko 5,000 and the person who is taking goods into the plastic bag, they have to pay 2,000 rupees fine. Okay, so don't use plastic bag. So this is uses of polyethylene. Now, the reference molecule is this. On the basis of this only, we'll give you the another molecules, which is this. Now, if you remove one hydrogen here with chlorine, CH2, double bond CH, and here we have Cl. When you do the polymerization of it, what you'll get? First of all, you tell me the name of this compound. The name of this compound is what?
Chloroethene.
Okay.
Vinyl chloride.
Yes. At vinyl position, we have chlorine present. So this molecule is vinyl chloride. And the polymerization of this gives you polyvinyl chloride. Ethylene gives polyethylene. Vinyl chloride gives polyvinyl chloride. Got it? The structure is what? If you draw the structure, CH2CHCl connected with the other molecule, CH2CHCl. CH2CHCl and so on. In short, if I write this as CH2CHCl and n times. Okay. The example of this PVC, the use of this in making pipes. Pipes banane mein use karte hain. Okay. One more thing I forgot to tell you here. What is the repeating unit? What is the repeating unit here? See, this n times means what? This is the repeating unit we have. So like this, you should know the repeating unit of the molecules. Like this one is easy, so you don't have to worry about it. They won't ask these questions also. But for others, we'll see what are the repeating units. There it is important. Okay, one kind of one, this kind of question they ask. Similarly, the repeating unit is this one here.
Is there a name for these repeating units?
It's vinyl chloride only for this one. Name they won't ask. They'll draw the structure. Now, if I ask you, these two are homopolymers or copolymers?
Homopolymers.
Yes, because the monomer is same. We have only one type of monomer. Right? That's why these are homopolymers, not copolymers. So like this, you have to keep in mind that whatever examples you are looking at, you should focus on the repeating unit, what kind of polymers it is, homopolymer, copolymer, and then what are the monomers. If it is homopolymer, fine, only one monomer will be there. If it is copolymer, then what are the two monomers we use for the production of this, and what is the uses? These two, three things you must focus on. Okay,